all good things has a start, and that start matters forever. In 2009, this great student of our alma mater had a vision. And today, as we, the tree of Mora spirits, are enjoying the seeds he sowed. He's a proud graduate of University of Moradu, a clergyman in drawing, a civil engineering degree holder from University of Stanford, founder of SL2 College, and also currently an advisor of EXO, and most importantly, the co-founder of our beloved Mora Spirit. Now I invite our great alumni, Mr. Dilanga Chintana Jayasundara, to address the gathering.
Thank you for that introduction. Can you guys hear me well? Can everybody hear me well?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah, well, all right. Yeah. So thanks again for having me here. Great to see such a big crowd, even on a Zoom setting on a Saturday evening. And also great to, you know, see how organization has grown, right, over the years. And again, you know, I always say, right, the reason Mora Spirit is here today is not, you know, just the beginning, but many, many, you know, crews, right? Thinking of it as like a startup, right? And thinking big and really starting with small initiatives and, you know, running very fast, right? So I like to always look at Mora Spirit and, you know, say one of my favorite sayings, think big, right? Start small and run fast, right? I hope that will stay with you guys if it's, you know, even just one phrase you want to take from today. So what I'll do is I'll quickly go over, right, two big reasons, you know, which we thought 12 years, 13 years ago, right, why this could be a success, why there was a need or like a gap, right? But what I would like to do is, you know, make it interactive, right? I mean, please, if you have any questions or if you want any further clarifications, make this interactive. And also, I hope there are other former Mora Spiriters here. I would love them to, you know, join in and, you know, at least tell a couple of things, right, about their experience during my time or even after that. Are there any other former Mora Spiriters right now in the call? Or?
Yes, sir. We have a few of them also.
Okay. Set it up as needed. So I'll get going. So first of all, I think there were two reasons even I kind of said in the video why we thought of starting Mora Spirit, right? So first one was for me, right, the overall benefits, right, to the wider undergraduate community in Sri Lanka. So when I was at Moratuwa, you know, I played three sports. I also organized certain sports, right? I was involved in, like, for example, starting the first international standard rowing course, right, at Bolgoda. I don't know whether you guys know that. So that's when, you know, when SAF came to Sri Lanka, when they wanted an international standard 2-kilometer course, that was the only place available, right? So through this organizing, right, organizing and sports management, we benefited, right, both him and myself benefited from doing stuff. So anyway, so when you look at the Sri Lankan university system, right, I mean, there's the top of the top cream, right, coming into universities. There's campus settings like think of Peradeniya or Moratuwa, right? That setting by Bolgoda or Hantana or whatever, right? That setting is ideal to bring that youth energy, right? Before youth enters the society, right? As leaders, that's the best grooming place, right? There's also, like, you know, sports is the one big part. And there's, you know, a budget allocated, not enough, but there's money allocated. There's like some structure, right, within the SLUSA and so on, right? However, we weren't seeing that being used well, right? I mean, when university students come in, there are very few options, right, they would get into. And we saw that big gap. And then later on, when I went to Stanford for postgraduate studies, I saw this what they call the college sports culture in US, right? Colleges, universities, right? There was like a lot of fanfare, right? Many stakeholders, the player, not the, just the players itself, but the university students, the alumni, even the local community, right? So I remember going to a American football game between University of Southern California in Los Angeles and Stanford University came to play them, right? The ground had 100,000 spectators, right, for a football game. The atmosphere was like amazing. And the other thing I saw was there was an economy behind that, right? From the person who would sell hot dogs outside to to like big companies, you know, flying their messaging like a banner on a helicopter and going around the field, right, to attract those people. So there's a huge economy, a lot of money around that, right? So that was one of the key initiators, right, for us, how to use this sports fanfare, how to use this energy, right, to bring about another small economy, right? So when we started Mora Spirit, right, the other universities picked it up very fast, like, you know, Japura Flames, I remember, right, Colombo's efforts, Pera Beats, and so on. So we could create that, you know, healthy rivalry. We could fire that rivalry in a nice way. So a couple of examples, right? We didn't have a proper scoreboard back then for inter-university events, even through slugs or in a typical year. So what we did was we created this scoreboard and we updated scores live, right? And that creates that rivalry then and there, right? Even like becoming champions of, you know, slugs, men's or women's overall, that became a thing, right? Even for the players itself, right? So with little things, right? Again, thinking big, but, you know, starting very small and doing something, right? So it was key, right? So I remember like talking this to two undergraduates back then, Shilan Pereira and Sami, right? Kandasami, who are, I think, both out of Sri Lanka now. And, you know, really like starting this on a Google spreadsheet and getting a website name and talking to Sports Council, and one of the rugby captains then was the Sports Council president, getting involved and just starting something very, very small, right? So you light a small fire. So as you can see, right? So what I want you guys to take is, right, every year, every crew, right, this year plus year coming years, you guys all can start those little fires within the Mora Spirit infrastructure, right? So let's go to the second reason, right? Second reason, I think, more relevant to you guys. Again, at Moroto, within University of Moroto, we being an engineering and a technological university, right? There's very little opportunity to get exposure beyond your, you know, typical academic activity, right? To the business world and so on. I'll tell you another little fact that I don't necessarily sell outside, right? So when I came to the university, right, like we were considered like top of the class, right? As I told you earlier, if you look at the peers, right? If you look at the whatever 200,000 peers you have in any even age group, any year, you were the top. But when you left Moratuwa, if you look at the same crowd and see where you are, it wasn't true, right? People have gone to work, people have acquired other skills. Even though you get a top engineering degree, when you pass out, you were in the top, whatever, like 5% or 2% in that peer group, right? Which was really bothering to us, right? If you give the best of a age group, the best education, and then when you come out of a university, if you're not at the top, right? There must be something wrong. So that's why, that's something you all should, I don't know how the situation now, but something you all should think, right? I mean, you're here because you've achieved something, you've proven something, right? Not to necessarily like, you know, wear it on your shoulder like a star or anything, but how you can use that opportunity to, right, move up, right? How can you gain an overall skill set, right? To be like, you know, be next generation leaders of, you know, Sri Lanka or the world, right? So the second reason was to create that, you know, training and development, give that exposure to the undergraduates at Moratuwa, right? So think of it as like an internship, right? 4-year internship you do if you're in there for 4 years, right? Like working in a real company, right? So Mora Spirit was specifically set up away from the university bureaucracy, right? So when we started doing stuff like even doing the rowing, organizing regatta, right, in Bolgoda, there are a lot of like bureaucracy or red tape, as we call it, right, to do things. So Mora Spirit was set a little far away from the University of Moratuwa administration. That's not to necessarily say that we want to be, you know, in disagreement or fight with the administration, but we want to, like, you know, there's youth energy there, there's passion, motivation, right? We want, and there's a need. So there should be a way, a vehicle to go do things, right? So that was the biggest thinking behind that. And it's, you know, amazing how people have, you know, like evolved over time, right? I mean, I was told we have about 116 the crew today, right? We probably started with like, you know, 4, right? And I'm told like there are like many different pillars. They're organized in nice, like not a tall hierarchy, but like a nice flat hierarchy. And you do like everything you would do in a typical business, right? From fundraising, marketing to a big operations layer in terms of, you know, news reporting and so on. So think of it as, you know, a real internship, and it's also, you have freedom, right, within Mora Spirit. Use that freedom. So again, I'll go back to my same first of the phrases I started with, right? You always have the freedom, right, to think big at Mora Spirit. You can, right, get something, talk to your pillar head or talk to whoever the person, right, get the support and start something very small, light that fire, right? And as it catches, right, as it catches up, right, you really go fast and, you know, accomplish a big thing, right? Even within your year, 1 year at Mora Spirit. So, I had a great run even after leaving Mora Tour, being with Mora Spirit for a couple of years, doing stuff. I had a great experience and great to see what it has grown to. I'm very happy about that. And wish Mora Spirit and, you know, the crew all the very best.